Welcome back. In the last video, we created our token on the Solana blockchain. If you didn't get to see that video, then check the description for the link to that video. Now that we have created our token, we have two choices: either launch the token on a launch pad or manually launch the token, providing our own liquidity. This tutorial assumes that you will be supplying your own money for the liquidity pool, which is the cheaper option. The only thing that I would recommend before we get started is that you have your contract audited for any security vulnerabilities and have your token's social media all built and polished so that investors can check out your socials and feel good about the token before deciding to purchase it. Alright, let's begin by creating a market ID and then we can launch our liquidity pool. First, we need to head back to the browser and log into your wallet if you have not already done so. Then open it up, find the token that you created, and left click on it. And then go to More, and then go to View on SolScan. And we want to keep this page open because this contains the address to our token. All right, and then you want to open up a new browser page. And you want to type create market Raydium and hit enter. All right, and you want the search result that is from Raydium, and it's the raydium.io create market. Click on that one. One thing that I would recommend before you get started would be to play around with this site a little bit. What I mean by that is just make sure that it doesn't crash on you. On some computers, this application has a tendency to crash, and while you're creating your OpenBook Market ID, you don't want to lose it. So just make sure that you aren't crashing with memory errors. If you are crashing with memory errors, you want to switch to a different browser or maybe even a different computer. The Raydium website is pretty stable on my computer, so I'm going to go ahead and get started. To start, go up to the top right where it says Connect Wallet and connect your wallet. Okay, and make sure the account that it wants to connect to is the correct one and press connect. Now here's where you want to paste your token contract address. Go back to SolScan and copy your token address and click the drop down for base token. Paste in your token contract address and then input the symbol for this token. And then input a name for this token. These should be the same name and symbol as you used to create the token contract address. When you're done, click Add User Token. Okay, and then select your token. And for the quote token, you want to click on the dropdown and choose Solana. For minimum order size, we're going to use 1,000. And minimum price tick size is going to be this. If you're unsure of the minimum order size and tick size that you should use for your token, there are some charts around the web. I'm using 1,000 minimum order size, so I want to use the tick size that is directly across from it. Once you have all the information filled in, you can click the button that says Create Market. All right, and you just have to confirm this transaction. The cost is going to be 2.78399 SOL, and then there's a small network fee. If you're fine with that, just click the confirm button. Okay, and you can see at the bottom right, there are two transactions that are being processed. We just need to wait for those to confirm, and then we can copy down our OpenBook Market ID for the next step. Okay, and that took about 30 seconds, so much quicker than last time. So just remember to turn off version transactions and then go into your settings and adjust the transaction priority. Now that we have our new market ID, let's copy that, keep it in a safe place because that's very important not to lose it. Next, we need to create the liquidity pool. Do that by selecting liquidity from the menu on the left. All right, so we're back at the liquidity page. We want to scroll down and we want to look for the section that says create pool and click on create pool. Okay, and here is where we need that OpenBook Market ID. So go grab that from your notes and paste it in the Open Market ID box. Click confirm. Okay, now we have to set the price and initial liquidity. Okay, so this is the amount of tokens that are going to go into the liquidity pool. It's about 84%. This is a utility token, so we're going to hold back a little bit for development and a little bit for marketing. And then we're going to add our SOL. And for the quote token in SOL, we're going to put up 10.34. And then we're going to set a time for the pool to launch. That way we don't have to rush around burning tokens and updating Dexscreener. Let's give ourselves a little room. So today is the 26th. We'll have it launch on the 27th. So the token launch start time is now going to be 4/27/24 at 1400 UTC. The creation fee is going to cost 0.4 SOL, which is required for new pools. And now we can click on initialize liquidity pool. All right, and you just want to confirm the transaction in your wallet. So the amount of liquidity that we're putting up plus the fee to create the liquidity pool is a little over 10.8 SOL, and roughly 17 billion of the USA tokens are going to go into the pool, and we're going to get back 1.32 million liquidity tokens that we'll be burning later. So if it all looks correct, then you're going to click confirm. Okay, and our pool has been confirmed. You created pool, AMM ID. Okay, so while we're waiting for the liquidity pool to launch, we can go ahead and burn our liquidity tokens now. Just open up a new browser window and then type in SOL incinerator, left click on it, and then you want sol-incinerator.com. Click on that and agree to the disclaimer. Go ahead and connect your wallet with the button at the top left here. Confirm the connection. And to burn liquidity tokens, we have to come down to the bottom left here where it says light and switch that to pro. Then we will get this tab up here. Click on LP. And here are the liquidity tokens from the pool that we just created. So we're just going to left click on them and then confirm burns on the right. And then you get a burning summary and a notice that this process cannot be reversed. So that's fine. Just click confirm and then confirm the transaction from your wallet. Okay, and now the burn has been completed. Your liquidity tokens have been burned, so the liquidity is locked forever. And the token will be available for trading at the time that you set for the liquidity pool to launch. If this video helped in any way, please consider giving this video a like and a subscribe so that more people can find this answer.